لله رب العالمين. قال في كتابه الكريم: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد العدناني برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين، وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، وبسند متصل بوسيلة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وبسند متصل بوسيلة مشايخنا إلى الإمام المتقن محمد بن إسحاق رضي الله عنه صاحب سيرة، أنه قال: الحمد لله الذي أعطاني هذا الغلام الطيب الأقداني، قد ساد في المهدي على الإيمان، أعيد بالبيت ذي الأركان حتى أراه بالغ البنيان. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Hadirin wa hadirat rahimakumullah, this is an honor to be invited here, alhamdulillah, to meet the Sheikh. I must say that when I was first told about him, our High Commissioner, His Excellency Dato' Sri Zakaria Sulong, when I gave the Mondulasu speech this year at the embassy, mentioned that, oh, we have an Ustaz Don Daniel coming from Malaysia. So we were staying the night with our ambassador, Malam Dua, and the Cikita. So we start Don Daniel. So I've never heard of his name before, Don. and you know, this is niyat, sama niyat of your grandfather to name the family Don here, so that everybody must notice this. And I remember Don. I remember Bajalah Gila-Gila in the 80s, there was this cartoon of some Don, I don't know nama. It's been done something else rather than that. But then definitely if you look at the archive of Majalah Gila-Gila, there is done something yang ada dalam Majalah Gila-Gila, and you think, oh, rupa hari ini, muka, the Sheikh, siiras muka. Subhanallah al-Azim. But this is, it's an amazing, so it's, I really, it's an honor to meet you, alhamdulillah. And to know that we know, you know, my friends like Habib Hassan, Sayyid Ali, Habib Ali, Zainal Ali, and Habib Nadir are from Malaysia, people that you know. So it really is, you know, we have had a matchmaking in heaven before. Semua dah diatur oleh Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. Bahasa Melayu karat, di Ramli berbenam. So it's not, I cannot compete with your Oxford Malay. So this is, I'm afraid, since the students here are all studying here, they have no excuse to listen to me, inshallah, in English. But I must say, having had the opportunity to be in the hadra of your company, to solat together, to makan juga sekali, mashallah. Wah, tempat makan pun style macam buat dekat Malaysia. With all the feeling of when you play, macam balik kampung lah tadi. And it is really, really nice. Of all of the places here, I have to say, being in Oxford since 2001, I have always been to majlis yang normally orang Arab kita yang buat, our, you know, Pakistani brothers, our British Muslims, we have some majlis of Maulud macam ni. But I've never been to a Malaysian one. So this is the first time that I've been to a... And you know, when Izzah, right? Izzah called, he sent an email sometime bulan November tahun lepas lah dia. Nak minta, nak jemput, nak datang untuk majlis Maulidur Rasul or something like that here to Nottingham. To do a program for Nottingham Berselawat. This was sometime in November. And I didn't answer her email, I think, until probably January end of January or something like that. And even then, oh, we couldn't make it because of the timing, you know, will not work. The original time that Aza gave, which was last week, or 2 weeks ago. Tiba-tiba, al-insanu yudakiru wallahu yukadiru. Kita merancang, Tuhan yang menentukan. Memang Aza, wherever you are, right? The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, innamal a'malu binniyat. All of our actions are, you know, based on our intention, and every likuli imri manawa, and every man and woman will get what he or she intended. And that is absolutely true here. So today I'm here now with the Nottingham Salawat. We were not planning this actually, so this is quite an extraordinary thing. Now, I will just say this, if you want me to speak on the wisdom, hikmahnya, nasheed, qasida, and the salawat. And it's interesting, that topic was given to me by, was it one of these MSE people, Puan Riba from MSD. I will just say to begin with that nasheed, the meaning of nasheed, what is the meaning of nasheed, what is the meaning of qasida, what is the meaning of salawat? To me, they all refer to the origin of our basic tradition of bersalawat. So nasheed is a form of bersalawat. Qasida is a form of bersalawat. So if you ask me as a, you know, a teacher, a professor, or a lecturer in Islamic studies, in philosophy or in theology, and if I have to put the definition, kalau kena, bersalawat tu okay, it's just sallallahu ala Muhammad, bila kita bersalawat atas Nabi kita, sallallahu ala Muhammad. The difference between qasida and nasheed is that nasheed would probably be the qasida Islam, meaning Islamic songs, whereas qasida is just simply song. So I hope all of you now know the meaning. It's a basic general definition. Nasheed basically means qasida Islam, ataupun Islamic songs, Islamic music in that case. Qasida songs in Arabic, because you can also have qasida jahiliyah and qasida Islamiyah. But bersalawat is a special commandment of our Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran itself, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Allah wa malaikatuhu yusalluna 'alan nabi. And this is interesting, hadirin wa hadirat rahimakumullah. The term salawat here. This is what I will always say to my students at the university. We have what we call in English an equivocal term. Dalam bahasa Arab, isim mushtarak. Nama dia salawat. Tetapi maksud dia, kalau digunakan oleh a different person and a different thing and a different entity, maksud dia boleh berlainan. Jadi equivocal term dalam bahasa Inggeris, ya, ataupun dalam bahasa Arab, isim mushtarak. You have one word. This comes from the Latin equivocal. Equa, which means sama. Vokal means kalimat. So kalimat yang mempunyai perkataan yang sama, wajah yang sama, tetapi makna dia berbeza-beza. Jadi when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, when Allah berfirman dalam Al-Quran Al-Karim, Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'ala nabi. Sesungguhnya, verily indeed God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? Wal malaika and the angels send salawat upon our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'alan nabi. So the meaning of salawat from Allah is different from the meaning of salawat from the malaika. And this is what we mean by the term salawat is an equivocal term. The nama satu word tapi different meaning. So for example in English we may have for example the term bang. Yeah, bang. The bank, the word bank we can use in English to mean the place where we put money in, bank. But it can also mean a noun where you can walk on the river bank. Okay, itu dah dua makna yang berlainan langsung. And the third meaning is, it's a verb. You can bank to the right, bank to the left. So here is a good example of the word bank in English is an equivocal term. And in Arabic, the term salawat, salah, is an equivocal term. Of course it is an equivocal term. Macam mana boleh you fikir Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'ala nabi? How can it be that Allah makes salat to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the same way that we make salat to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Kita punya salat zuhur dengan asar tadi kan bukan 4 rakaat, 2 rakaat, 2 rakaat. That is not how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes salat to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, hadirin wa hadirat rahimakumullah. This is why bila kita mengaji dengan ulama, dengan tok guru-tok guru kita, dengan ustaz-ustaz kita yang bertauliah dan ada ijazah sanad muttasilah, for example, bila kalau kita only mengaji dengan our ulama and our tok guru yang bertauliah, for example, then kalau kita tak just buka kamus apa maksud berselawat ni, solat ni, taklah kita confuse kalau kita nak terjemahkan innallaha, sesungguhnya Allah, wal malaikat And the angels, you saw Luna, solat Alanda. Kita kena tanyakan diri kita, apa maksud solat di sini? So the ulama say, kita punya jumhur of the ulama, they say, as-salatu minallahi ar-rahmah, was-salatu minal malaikati al-istighfar, was-salatu minna, yani from all of us, from haiwan included, from human beings, and also daripada pohon-pohon. Tadi the Sheikh mentioned about the cerita about the pohon, you know, and how the batu-batu, they all can also send salawat to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So when they send salawat to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when we send the salawat to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so the ulama say the meaning of this is as-salatu minna at-tadarru'u wa-du'a. The meaning is doa. Itulah maksud salawat yang ada dalam tajuk ini. The wisdom of nanti pasukan untuk salawat, the meaning of salawat ini is basically making doa. So in other words, what? Making doa to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is different. So when we use Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusallun ala nabi, the meaning of salawat therefore Allah is Allah mengantarkan rahmat kepada baginda Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that when the malaika send salawat to the nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the malaika alaihi wasallam in this case send istighfar for the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But when we then do the salawat, we are sending dua to the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is the meaning. Now I hope you can see daripada perkataan as-salat. Satu perkataan saja dalam bahasa Arab, di mana perkataan nama sarang ini ada bermacam-macam makna. And itu pentingnya belajar berguru, because if you do not have a teacher who can teach you the meaning of salat here, then if you just use, if you're learning Arabic in English, for example, the Hans Word Dictionary, or the Maulid, Kamus Maulid, Kamus Melayu, apa-apa, saya tak belajar bahasa Arab, I'm not sure. There must be, kan, or something. Ada kamus bahasa Melayu Arab, kamus apa? Kamus Tulab, for example. Then, if you open the word solat without the teacher, then you think confused. So, Allah mengatakan solat pada Rasulullah. So, the meaning of solat here is rahmah from Allah, istighfar from the malaika, and doa from all of us. Now, hadirin wa hadirat rahimahullah, if you understand that, very simply now, all we have to say here is, look at this beautiful hadith of the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when Abu Hurairah radhiyallahu anhu narrated in, you know, one of the books of Sahih, in this case Sahih Muslim, annahu qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, man salla alayya wahidatan sallallahu alayhi ashran. This is hadith Sahih, tak dipertikaikan. Brilliant, wonderful hadith. Sekarang with your newfound knowledge of tafsir dan takwil dan faham maksud solat minallah, minal malaika, minna daripada kita, now you can now understand this hadith better. Barang siapa tadi? Siapa-siapa? Man-man. Man. Whosoever. Man. Yeah. Whosoever. Barang siapa? Whosoever. Solat alaya. Make solat on me. This is what the Prophet said. Meaning, barang siapa berselawat upon me. Meaning, whosoever makes doa for me. Masya Allah, right? Man salla alayya wahidatan, whosoever makes one salawat for me, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sallallahu jawab, sallallahu, then Allah will send salawat alayhi to us, to the one who makes salawat, ashran, 10 times. What you first did. Now, it means what? Kalau kita baca satu doa untuk our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, datang pada kita 10 rahmat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Azim. Azim. So this is amazing. So the benefits of nasheed and qasidah, which are forms of salawat, right, are innumerable. Incalculable, tak boleh nak dikira. In fact, kalau nak dikira pun, times 10 kalau nak dikira. So, kali 10. Jadi, the basis of my syarahan today is basically to say, if you want me to say, what is the hikmah yang nasyid dan berkasidah ni? Okay? The hikmah dia adalah, bila kita bernasyid dan berkasidah, we will get 10 times of rahmat from Allah SWT, tanpa kita tahu pun apa sebenarnya rahmatnya. And I want to just share with you three stories, three things for you to see. So if Baginda Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, barang siapa man sallallahu alaihi wahidatan, barang siapa berselawat pada aku sekali, sallallahu dan Allah akan berselawat akan dia alaihi asyran, 10 kali. I want to share with you, therefore kalau kita baca satu selawat dapat 10 rahmat, I'm going to share only with you 3 rahmat yang we could share, so that we don't have to spend, you know, otherwise 10 rahmat, and as the Sheikh mentioned earlier, nak kupas dan berlayar nanti I have to go back to Oxford this evening, and tomorrow we have this thing in Sheffield again, I think, you know, and so that would be wonderful to see some of you then tomorrow. So what are the 3 rahmat that I want to share with you? هذا من فضل ربي صلى الله عليه.
ما شاء الله
ما شاء الله.
هذا من بركة الشيخ. ما شاء الله. This is very good. Now I three. Just think of it, three. The first. You know, when I was in Belfast before, went to University of Belfast, I went to Oxford University, I was the imam there, the local mosque there, and like your like students over here, we would have majlises. Tiap-tiap, kadang-kadang minggu lah, baca yasin dengan tahlil, dengan qasidah, maulud, selawat. And we normally have our majlis like here, like this building, we would have it in the students' union. Okay. Now in Queen's University Belfast ni student union, dia punya student union ni dia punya tingkat bawah macam ni. Dia ada a concourse, a bit of a hall there, and there are 2 rooms. One big room on this side and another big room on this other side. This one room on this other side ni tempat yang selalu kita buat zikir, buat selawat, buat tahlil, buat yasin, you know, buat kuliah agama, yeah. But selalu kalau kita buat kuliah agama, kita mesti ada nasyid dan qasidah lah supaya senang. You know, tarikkan orang, these are the things that people love, you know, it makes it easy for people to come to you, inshallah, as part of the da'wah work, alhamdulillah. So, on the one side of the student union is the room where we have our majlis. Across it is another room which is the bar. The student union bar. Right? Great. In case if those of you do not know, I'm sure the ustaz dah tahu dah, inshallah. But some of you may come from Malaysia, ni bukan bar meaning jadi lawyer, it's a bar where they, you know, they can get drunk, right? Now, there was one when we were sitting down in our majlis, and we were, you know, having our majlis, singing, you know, our nasheed and qasidah like Tala Al Badr Al Aina, probably the most recognizable Muslim salawat, right? Then, back in the 90s, there was this one sister, Malaysian sister, mashallah. And of course, I know her, and I will not mention the name for obvious reasons. She, like most of you, are students who come from Malaysia, alhamdulillah. Well done for coming to study in this Negeri Barat, alhamdulillah. You've done so well, you know, you did well with your A-levels, and then you know, you're there, you're here now in Nottingham University, and some of you come from outside of Nottingham even. So just like one of you, a girl, who, when she came from Malaysia, first dia datang to Malaysia, to Belfast, she kind of, you know, and then she did, I think it was medicine, you know, and then she became a doctor, right? But what happened to her was that, in a sense, she lupa daratan, actually. So when she came here, she was very kind of, you know, she knows about her religion and everything, but then she moved away from the religion in the few years that she had been. You know, so dia tak suka nak, you know, join dengan the Malaysians and all that, and she kept to herself, and then essentially she just moved away, and then she then had a boyfriend, you know, fine, you know, this is, you know, boyfriend, tapi, you know, she considered herself to be not belonging among the Muslims lah, put it that way, and pergi masuk, for example, in the bar like this, drinking. Astaghfirullahaladzim. There are people who do this. And we must recognize the fact that kita ni one day could do that as well. We must not pass judgment on people like this. That's why kita diajarkan oleh Allah Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. You know, kita minta doa daripada Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala untuk kita apa? Ada husnul khatimah. Right? So that we ask for good ending so that we don't have a bad ending. So you should not judge your friends just because they do this and then you dah start pulau dia tak mau cakap dengan dia because dia dah buat macam. No, you must do your best to befriend her. But in her case, she wanted to keep it. But to cut the long story short, she you know, essentially regarded herself as no longer Muslim lah. No longer, you know, she doesn't want to practice the faith. This is shocking for Malaysian. Shocking for Malaysian. So she went, and then she has this. She's in a relationship, and then she had problems. Unfortunately, okay, please don't say ah, padan. Please, you know, exactly, because this is every one of us is tested by Allah Subhanahu wa Taala in different ways, and we will all, you know, if we're not careful, then we might fall into that. So she was then tested by Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. She had difficulties. She broke up with this boyfriend. And she was not doing well in her workplace. And she was basically then started to drink. And then started, you know, to comfort her. And then one night, when we were having our majlis, and then suddenly the one qasidah came up. It was like Tala'an Qadu'a Alayya. And this girl who has moved away from Islam for a while now, more than a couple of years, when she heard the song, this is when she was really at the bottom deck. Dia dah sangat derita sangat. Dia feel very, very sad. She felt very, very sad. You know, she was feeling even nak bunuh diri, that type of feeling, you see. And then when she heard this song, she heard the salawat. Keluar daripada bar tu, dia dengar maybe one of the pintu terbuka while you were singing, you see. She heard this song, dia teringat, ni opah dia ajar anak lagu dia. Dia punya grandmother taught her this song when she was growing up. And when she heard that song, she cried. She dapat rasa hati tu macam dipegang oleh someone. She just... Everyone getting the vibe. Relax. So she, because of just that nasheed, or because of just that qasida, it changed her life. Because the rest became history. She then taubat. She came and she opened up, duduk kat belakang. You know, dah semalu takut maybe orang tak mau sell dia because she had taken off her tudung and everything. You know, and just, you know, and she was crying and crying and crying. Just because of this song. Subhanallah. Wa man yu'azzim sha'air Allah fa innaha taqwal qulub. How true it is. That what the Shaykh mentioned earlier. When you want to agungkan, in this case, the shi'ar of Allah is this, the salawat for example, then Allah will make your heart in connection with Him. Ala bi dhikrillah tatma'inul qulub. And it is only through the dhikr of Allah, it is only through making a connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you will find peace and contentment in this life. So this lady dengar lagu saja, bukan dia nyanyi, dia dengar lagu, dia teringat lagu, songs in my head. Songs in my head. Dengar lagu saja, terus bertaubat. Terus. Baru keluar dari bar, baru keluar dari student senior bar. Even bimbing dia mungkin mabuk sikit pun, dia boleh dengar lagu ni, dia terus beritahu. And bertawad, and return back to the path. MashaAllah. Allahu Akbar! Sallallahu ala Muhammad! That is amazing. This is the meaning when Abu Nu'aym, for example, Isfahani, in his Ihliya, in his, you know, very famous hadith, when he narrated the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, isnadi da'if, even though this hadith has isnad da'if, but it is, you know, you please take it from me and Imam Nawawi and others, just because hadith ta'if memang boleh digunakan, especially untuk digunakan untuk naik semangat, untuk tarikh wa tarhib, not untuk keluarkan hukum apa yang wajib dan haram. But here, we can use it here, and we must use it. So I hope you do not belong among those who allergy dengan hadith ta'if. Hadith maudu, allergy tak apa. But not ta'if, please. Because even if there is 1% possibility that the Prophet SAW could have said it, you cannot, you don't want to deny that possibility. MashaAllah. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, as narrated by Imam Abu Nu'aym, who was among the Salafis, by the way, who Salafi Salih, in the time of, you know, the first three generations of Islam, said, they narrate, "Man amila bima'alima warathah Allahu ilma ma lam ya'lam." Beautiful hadith. Many ulama got to this hadith. Imam Ghazali, Imam Nawawi, ramai, masyaAllah. Barang siapa, whosoever act on what he or she knows, right? Then Allah will give him or her warathallahu, Allah will inherit him or her. Maknanya Allah will bagi hadiah, will inheritkan untuk dia benda yang dia tak tahu. Will give him knowledge that he or she does not know. And this is why one of the Imam of the Salaf, Abu Talib al-Makki, in his sharah of this hadith, he says, "Man amila bi'ishrin ma ya'lamu." Kebarang siapa, whosoever acts, or even a tenth of what they know, even 1/10 yang dia tahu. Kalau barang siapa yang mengamalkan daripada ilmu dia 1/10, even a tenth of what he or she knew or knows, right? "Man amila bi'ishrin ma ya'lamu warathahallahu ilma yajhalu." Allah will give him knowledge which he or she did not know. This is what happened to this lady. Dia amalkan sikit, dia itu pun bukan amal pun dengar saja. Ya Allah. This is why Imam Ibn Ruslan, our great fakir among the fuqaha of the Syafi'iyah, in his beautiful pantun, kita semua berpantun, qasidah is pantun, basically, the bahasa Arab. You know, he says in a beautiful pantun, "Fa'amal walau bil'ushri kazzakati, takhruj binuril ilmi min zulumati." Amalkanlah ilmu yang ada pada kamu itu, walaupun even if it is 10% of what you know, such as paying the zakat, right? Even if it is a little, you know, you keep to, you know, you amalkan. Even if it is a little, you amalkan what you know. Even if it is 10% of what you know, then if you do that, takhruj binuril ilmi min zulumati, you will be liberated. You will be taken out min zulumati, daripada kegelapan dan kejahilan. Kegelapan itu, to the nur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How true is it? How true is it? Amazing. Amazing. So even if it is a little that you know, this is the mark of the Salaf. Many of the Salaf during the time of the Salaf al-Salih, they may know little thing. They were not muftis and ulama. Tapi they act fully on what they do. So, that is an example of one rahmah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by just this one salawat. Dia dengar satu salawat je. Maybe it was sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It touched her heart and she broke down because of that. How true, and there is a God. Memang ada Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So how true is it? I hope you can see. Man sallallahu alaihi wahidatan, ya Allah, sallallahu alaihi, alaiha in this case. Ashra, that was satu benefit. Yang, you know, it's a supra-rational thing. You cannot rationalize it. So this is why my teaching is always in Oxford. For example, those who come outside of the university when I teach in the Masjid Jami' over there. So we have Fiqh Syafi'i ataupun Akidah, you know, Usuluddin, Sanusiyah ataupun Tasawuf, for example, Imam Ghazali, for example, some people, students coming from all over, and I always remind them of this, that the importance of not only having zikir ilmiah, to have a kuliah, pengajian, tapi kena ada zikir ruhaniyah as well. A spiritual zikir, not only an intellectual zikir. So when you go to classes, you go to your intellectual zikir. But, mashallah, the balance and the right thing is to have a combination of both. And this is the one of the wisdom of nasyid, you know, the berkasidah. Bila kita mengaji di pondok-pondok dari pesantren-pesantren, for example in Indonesia, one of the beautiful traditions in Morocco, one of the beautiful traditions is that when you dah habis mengaji kitab, syarah kitab, for example, the Tok Guru syarah kitab, habis saja majlis, "Maulaya salli wa sallim daiman abadan ala habibika khairil khalki kullihimi. Maulaya salli wa sallim daiman abadan ala habibika khairil khalki kullihimi. Ya Rabbi bil Mustafa bali maqasidana waghfir lana ma mada ya wasiyal karami. Ya Rabbi bil Mustafa bali maqasidana waghfir lana ma mada ya wasiyal karami." Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik alayhi. Imagine kalau dah nak try buat matematik ataupun some difficult equation you have to go through in your kuliah ilmiah. Lepas tu at the end of the majlis dan buat usuluddin ke fiqah ke hadis ke, and then you have that just beautiful song just to touch the heart, just to immerse yourself, just to tamkin, just to make sure that the ilmu tu gugur daripada diri kita. Alhamdulillah, such a beautiful tradition. So hadirin wa hadirat rahimakumullah, that's one. Another rahmah, I hope to benefit from that, that we see that. Very briefly, the second rahmah that I notice myself, you know, in the West, and some of you want me to speak on this very briefly, how people view Islam and how the people here view our Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, particularly after 9/11, you know, unfortunately, not very good. A few years back, in Davos, you know where Davos is, of course? Barbarikita, we just had a Davos meeting in Switzerland. This is where all the world leaders come together, all the business leaders come together again. There was one year, about, I think, just after 7/7, when the bombing in London, 2005. There was a Davos meeting that year, following in 2006. People felt so much incense, you know, apa sal yo orang agama Islam, you know, they take up arms and they, you know, they are killing civilians and so on and so forth. And there are many people who are rational who feel that way, unfortunately. That year in Davos, some Yusuf, you may have heard, and of course Yusuf Islam, for example, you would have heard for sure. So they organized for that year, especially they will do nasheed, malam satu extravaganza nasheed at Davos. Just like this year, I think the Malaysians organized a Malaysia night or something like that in Davos. To malam tu, they organized a nasheed in Davos. And when they organized this, some Yusuf, for example, sang in a salawat and various other things, nasheed, of course, Yusuf Islam, you know. And after the majlis, these are non-Muslims, this is the Torah of Islam. When they polled, when Gallup did the poll, immediately a few days after that, when they polled among the leaders who came there on their views about Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Rasul Muhammad in Islam, the negatives went down and the positives went up. Just because these people who don't even know the meanings of some of these songs, dengar the salawat of the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So hadirin wa hadirat sekalian rahimakumullah. This is another example where, again, you cannot explain it actually. Through hearts, through songs, through things that touch your emotion, for example, these are things which is important. Is important, but you may not realize. So that is the only contribution when it comes to, wow, the pandangan orang barat tentang terhadap agama Islam dan terhadap junjungan Nabi Muhammad kita sallallahu alaihi wasallam boleh bertukar just because of salawat, just because of bernasyid, and just because of berkasidah. Untuk orang yang memang tak percaya Tuhan, when dia realize, sebenarnya orang Islam ni pun boleh nyanyi juga. Bukan dia nak attack. It's true. So these are the unseen, knowledge of the unseen that comes just because man amila bima alima warasahullahu ilma malamnya. If you act on what you know, no matter how little you know, then God will give you knowledge of things that you do not know. The mysteries of this world, mashallah, that you will be able to see. Finally, the third rahmah, coming home very closely now to our region, to the Nusantara, is Allah Yarham Pi Ramli. You know, this is Nottingham berselawat. Now I can tell you, Pi Ramli berselawat. Allah Yarham Pi Ramli. And one of the things I love about him, of course, is that, as all of you know, and I don't need to share this with you, sometimes when I speak to non-Malaysians, especially among the Arabs and the Pakistanis and the British, in your audience, I have to explain to them who Pi Ramli is. So alhamdulillah, thank God I don't need to do that. So you know Pi Ramli is evergreen. Hey, genius, yeah. Everybody know that Pi Ramli is genius sangat lah. MashaAllah. Terrornya how he thinks he is. But do you know his secret? Do you know his secret? His secret is Pi Ramli berselawat. Wallahi al-azim. Subhanallah. It's very true. So he, one of his marks of genius is that, you know, he grew up daripada Penang ni background, same as like his Tok Syed here. So, grew up with all the Barzanji, dengan Selawat, dengan Bertasida, and all the lagu-lagu Selawat kan. So bila he became a famous director, you know, then he, and this is why he was a genius, he was able to make use of the best from the Islamic tradition with what he then learned later on. Even from the Western tradition, macam reading Shakespeare, you know, for example, King Lear. Tu kalau tahu cerita Tiga Abdul tu, tapi King Lear lah. Jalan cerita dia, sikit-sikit. Tapi here, the point is that he was able to kind of combine both the best of what dunia punya tradition yang ada dan daripada tradisi Islam itu semua. So, what is the example of this? So, for instance, tadi, you all sang
Qalama ashku arami ya nurul wujud Qalama ashku arami ya nurul wujud Wa unadi ya yatihami ya ma'adina al-jud Wa unadi ya yatihami Ya Madina Jud.
But we are going to have that just after this. But Talama Ashurami is one of the most famous negeri. One of the most famous kasidah dan nasyid daripada negeri Arab, daripada Syria, daripada Morocco, daripada semua negeri Arab. Kalau nak nyanyi lagu kasidah Talama Ashurami ini very famous. Lagu tu memang lagu dia macam tu. Ditransmitkan daripada negeri Arab. Memang sure. Tak boleh ni lagu ni datang dari Nusantara. Jadi memang sure Piramli Allah Yarham Piramli ciplakkan dalam you know dalam cerita famous Ali Baba Bujang Lapuk bila dia perkenalkan Sarimah. Alangkah indah di waktu pagi burung terbang bersiul-siul. Terbang bebas di angkasa tinggi, hidup bersenam hati-hati. Talama Ashurami. I mean, the fact that Allah Yarham Piramli grew up with these songs bila kita mengajikan negeri Arab memang dah berkurun lamanya. 500 tahun, 600 tahun orang ulama Arab karang kan. And then Allah Yarham Piramli, wow. That's why, you know, he was successful. Dia bersalawat, dalam lagu tu bersalawat. Jadi top 10 or something like that in this day. You know, another one is this. Apa ni? Aci, aci, buka pintu. Nana, lihat pukul satu. Jangan takut burung hantu. Apa lagi? Nana, tongkat terbangku. Ten. Ya Rasulullah, salamun alaihi ya Rafi Ashani wa tarajian fataya dirotal alamiya uhailal juni wal karami. Sallallahu alaihi. But on that one, hadirin wa hadirat sekalian, liriknya ditulis di negeri Arab, tapi lagu ini datang dari Nusantara. Yang padat. Tapi yang Talama Ashurami, lagu ditulis di negeri Arab dan dia punya lirik pun daripada negeri Arab. So this one, Piramli ni genius lah. Ya Nabi Salam Alaikah tadi memang lagu Aceh Cepat itu memang datang daripada tradisi Nusantara. So hadirin wa hadirat rahimakumullah, look at Piramli punya secret of his success was Piramli berselawat. So what we have is, number one tadi, rahmat satu tadi, kita nampak orang yang dah lari daripada agama Islam. Orang yang dah bukan saja buat maksiat, tapi dah nak bunuh diri pun. Just because of satu selawat dapat selamatkan diri dia. Masya Allah, nafsu dia. Masya Allah, Masya Allah, nyawa. Nombor dua, hikmah nombor dua, rahmah yang nombor dua tadi. Ya, orang barat yang dah menyampah rasa dengan orang Islam lepas 7-7 punya bombing tu boleh bertukar hati pula, boleh dengar qasidah, salawat. Dan rahmat yang nombor tiga, bila kita nampak Masya Allah, Piramli Allah Yarham Piramli sendiri tu, you know, dia punya secret of success is dalam berselawat. mungkin dia tak cakap, tapi masya Allah kita nampak. Dan sebagai sepatutnya ulama dan PhD scholars dan scholars ni patut boleh analyse. Kalau boleh nampak itu alhamdulillah. And I got this confirm from memang dia punya kenalan anak murid dia Cikgu Yusuf, Cikgu Yusnoel. Alhamdulillah. So hadirin wa hadirat rahimakumullah, those are the three rahmat. So man salla alayya wahidatan sallallahu alaihi ashra. Barang siapa bersalawat akan Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam sekali, maka Allah Subhanahu wa taala akan selawat akan kamu 10 kali. Dan tadi saya cuma bagikan 3 hikmah, 3 rahmat daripada Allah Subhanahu wa taala. So I hope you can find in your own lifetime 7 other rahmat from Allah Subhanahu wa taala. So we just have a short indeed break here with some song before we have a Q&A with this song that I want all of you to sing together with the Sheikh. And ni nama dia lagu selawat yang tok guru kita ajarkan kita di Malaysia, di Nusantara, selawat Adnan. You know, and this selawat liriknya datang daripada negeri Arab dan lagunya datang dari Nusantara. And if you want to know the soul of the Nusantara, soul dengan roh jiwa orang Melayu Islam kita di Nusantara ni, sama ada di Indonesia, di Brunei, di Singapura dan di Malaysia, then you look no further than this song. So if you want to capture the soul of the Nusantara ini. And very briefly, this song, Salla Alaikallahu Ya Adnan, this song is the very first salawat. You can take that from me. I give you ijazah on this today. This is the inilah selawat yang pertama kali dikarangkan. Siapa tulis ni? Kalau mengaji pondok-pondok kalau di Malaysia atau di di pondok-pondok di pesantren, misalnya ustaz-ustaz itu ajar, ini kadang-kadang dipanggil selawat Adnan, kadang-kadang dipanggil qasidah Abdul Muttalib. Abdul Muttalib? Iya. Nenek moyang, indik datuk Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam yang karangkan ini. Really? So jadi ada antara ustaz-ustaz kita baru belajar bahasa Arab, Jordan alhamdulillah, baru balik dari Madinah, 3-4 tahun belajar bahasa Arab ke situ. Baru ada belajar bahasa Arab tapi tak gunulah dengan lagu ni. Jadi bila dia tengok dalam lagu ni, cuba kita tengok line 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12. Line yang ke-12 ada haqqan 'alal islami wal imani. Macam mana boleh Abdul Muttalib karangkan selawat ni? Islam belum ada lagi. Macam Syekh tadi kata, wahyu baginda Rasulullah sampai pada umur 40. Si macam mana ni? Mauduk. Ya bid'ah langsung. Haram, tak boleh dibaca. Ini lah khurafat. I mean the fear of unknown. Imam Ghazali kata annasu a'da'u ma jahilu. Orang manusia ni takut pada annasu a'da'u ma jahilu. Manusia ni people are enemies of what they are ignorant of. Macam Cicero, one of the famous Western philosophers, kata dalam bahasa Latin, dan non quod non intelligent. People condemn the things they don't know, they don't understand, they condemn. Adakah macam tu ke akhlak orang Islam? You should not throw the baby along with the bathwater. Just because you tak faham, just because you tak tahu, ataupun nenek moyang you kata ini dikarangkan oleh Abdul Muttalib, lepas tu baru belajar Arab sikit dan nampak Islam dengan iman, alamak. Ini mau tu, therefore tak boleh baca. And the ulama, ada kalam ulama, memang ada kaedah ulama yang famous, right? Ma la yutraku kulluhu, la yutraku kulluhu. If you do not understand something, kalau tak faham sikit, jangan buang yang seluruhnya. Don't throw the baby along with the bathwater. So when I found one of our Malaysian ustaz in my visit to Jordan some years ago saying that, oh, dia tak boleh nak nyanyi about it because of this one, the maudu, I say man, you not miss the barakah of this song. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, hadirin wa hadirat rahimakumullah. So now, you know, I will tell you, because today is not the syarah for this, another time inshallah. Line number 2, 3, 4, 5. Line nombor 2, 3, 4, 5 ni memang karangan Abdul Muttalib. Memang karangan Abdul Muttalib. What is it? Alhamdulillahilladzi a'tani, dalam khutbah saya tadi when I began dengan sanad, ya. Alhamdulillahilladzi a'tani هذا الغلام الطيب الأرداني قد صرف المهدي على الغلمان يعيد بالبر ذي الأركان حتى أراه بالغ البنيان. You know, when Abdul Muttalib, when he was born, when the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born, what happened? Dalam hadith yang sahih, we know, and you know, he went, you know, Aminah sent word that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born, and he was born in a miraculous fashion. Miraculous fashion, dia born, wow, dia punya, you know, tak ada apa, placenta, everything is clean. Abdul Muttalib came and took the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his grandson, so happy. He went where? Straight to the Kaaba. Depan pintu Kaaba itu. And dia berdoa kepada Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bukan saja berdoa, dia in this case giving thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by saying this. Alhamdulillahilladzi a'tani. Praise be to Allah who has given me. Ya, puji-pujian kepada Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yang memberikan aku. Hadzal ghulam at-thayyib al-ardani. Baby ini, this baby boy. Hadzal ghulam at-thayyib al-ardani, yang thayyib al-ardan. Bila dia dilahirkan, baju dia bersih. Di placenta di clean. This is Abdul Muttalib saying that. And then he goes on to say, "Qad sada fil mahdi 'ala al-ghilmani," yang akhirnya ini doa dia lah. Yang akan this the baby ini qad sada fil mahdi, walaupun masih lagi di mahad apa? Cradle, dia dah jadi sayyid segala semua baby yang ada outside of Mekah, outside of himself, of the Prophet of Allah SWT. So he's become a leader to all the other babies. Memang betul this doa. But this is what Abdul Muttalib is asking for from Allah Subhanahu wa ta'ala. U'iduhu bil baiti dhil arkani. I ask you, or you know, to give protection to him. U'iduhu macam a'udzubillahi minasyaitanir rajim. Ta'ud. Berilah, you know, protection. U'iduhu, berilah protection to this baby. Bil baiti, dengan tabarruk, with the blessing of this Kaabah. Bil baiti dhil arkani. Bil baiti dhil arkani maknanya tak Kaabah. Hadirin wa hadirat rahimakumullah, remember when did the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born? Tahun apa? Tahun amfil. Tahun gajah. Tahun gajah. What happened in the year of the elephant? Abraha, you know, yeah, who was a Christian daripada Habsyah, a general from Habsyah ni, dia bina kanisa, cathedral, dia bina gereja, cathedral di Sana'a, di Yemen. So big. And he wanted the people of Arabs, the people of Arabia to go and pray there. Tapi dia bodoh, pergi lagi dekat Mekah. Tak mau datang pergi ke sana. Walaupun dia pergi berbina dia punya gereja dekat sana tu, sampaikan cantik, dia benda-benda letak emas dan everything, tapi dia want to go. So dia, because of dia punya jealousy, cemburu, he went to attack Mekah. What happened? The rest is history, of course. Abdul Muttalib famously went to the Kaaba. Ni bukan dekat rumah dia. Ha, ini dia dalil ulama to show kenapa memang boleh, you know, buat tabarruk to makan, orang kata dalam bahasa Arab, tempat mungkin saya. Because this is the example. Abdul Muttalib went to the Kaaba and he prayed, "A'udhu, u'iduhu, protect all of us, u'iduhu," you know, with the barakah of this house of God, protect us from the attack of the army of Abraham. And the rest of us is history. I mean, you have the Abadi coming to destroy it. So this is the second time only, second time only when Abdul Muttalib went to the Kaaba to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like what he did to protect Mecca. But this time for the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is why he said, "U'iduhu bil baiti dhil arkani." Hanya dua kali saja dalam hayat. This is the second. Wow. Apa doa dia? Berikanlah protection to this boy, to this baby boy, menggunakan berkat tabarruk dan be, you know, bil baiti dhil arkani, with your power of Allah. Supaya apa? Hatta arahu balighal bunyani, sampailah aku dapat nampak dia dibesarkan. Hatta, until I can see him, not balik dalam maksud fiqah dari sini, tapi nanti dia kan, hatta arahu, until I can see him, balighal bunyani, stand on his two feet. Allah Subhanahu wa taala memang makbulkan doa Datuk Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Bukan saja dapat dia nampak Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam walk on his two feet, tapi melangkaui Halimah Sa'diyah yang ditinggalkan umur 4 tahun melampaui wafatnya Nabi, wafatnya umi Nabi kita sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Aminah, umur 6 tahun. Sampaikan umur 8 tahun dia duduk dengan tok.
Masya-Allah.
So the Allah has given answers to the prayer. So this lines number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 line 3 to line 7 ni kalam Abu Muttalib direkodkan oleh Imam Ibn Ishaq dalam kitab sirahnya. And later on our one of our famous Imam Syafi'i punya mazhab dalam Imam Syafi'i mufassir yang terkenal dalam mazhab Syafi'i, Imam Ibn Kathir radhiyallahu anhu dalam Al-Hidayah wa Nihayah dia record that again the same song. So now we can go back to this ustaz from Medina or whatever or Jordan say, excuse me, this is a qasidah Abdul Muttalib. Tapi yang lain ni, yang bait-bait yang lain, yang puisi yang lain ni dikarangkan, qasidah yang lain ni dikarangkan oleh imam-imam yang tak mau diketahui nama dia. Some ulama kata Syekh Abdul Qadir Jilani qaddasallahu. Some kata Imam Al-Ghazali sendiri. Tambah some of these other some of these other lines. Dia punya selawat, dia punya chorus pun sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. Yes, someone else lah yang tambahkan. You know, so and that is why our ulama dengan dalam kumulnya they did not want to be known, because you know they don't want to nak tunjuk dan menuduh-nuduhnya. So hadirin wa hadirat rahimakumullah, this song we will sing together so that kita masukkan dalam hati kita supaya you now understand this is not the full syarah of this song. But I hope when you study with your top guru, with your ulama dan berguru dan bersanad, for example, then you now know the history of this song. You now know the meaning of this song. Bermakna lagi bila kita amalkan selawat ini, insyaAllah. So now you know how true it is, how beautiful this song is. And memang, salat alaik Allahu ya Adnan. May Allah, you know, give salawat onto the family of Adnan. In this case, the Prophet of Allah SAW. Itu Adnan tu nama, surname nama baginda Rasulullah SAW. Nama keluarganya. Masya Allah. Ya, Safwatur Rahmani. Indeed. So let us sing the song. We have a group percussions ready, indeed. This is what I promised for me, I think. So that we will sing. And you must all, inshallah, dengan semangat. Join together.
Cepat, pantat. Kau jangan nak.
So everybody has the sheet now. So hadirin wa hadirat rahimakumullah, I hope you can see inshallah anyway the hikmah, the wisdom of nasheed, qasidah dan berselawat. Lagu Nusantara, walaupun liriknya daripada Abdul Muttalib asasnya dan ditambah oleh imam-imam terkemuka seperti Imam Ghazali, Imam Syekh Abdul Qadir Jilani dan lainnya, terutama chorus dia di situ, jadi kita ramai-ramaikan terutama di negeri barat sini supaya anak-anak kita balik. This is free for you, please don't eat this here. Haram. Haram. Haram dighairin. Membalik, so bawa balik, ajar ke anak-anak kita, siapa-siapa yang duduk kat negeri ni yang tak tahu selawat, protect your children so that you get the protection of that lady I mentioned to you. Supaya dia ajarkan lagu ni supaya you will always be protected, insyaAllah. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barikani wa ala
Adat.
Hadirin wa hadirin rahimakumullah, I hope kita semua insaf dan taubah insyaAllah. From that song, you can see how easy it is for you to cry. You should take the time and occasion for you to cry precisely. And especially to husband, suami yang ada kat sini. Ini your chance tu kalau nak marah-marah, ni time ni nak jelik, masa ni lah. Not to your bini back home. Huh? So this is why one of the other unseen hikmah of the nasyid, qasidah dan berselawat. Alhamdulillah di hadza wa astaghfirullah wa la ilaha illa anta ya rahmanir rahim. So let's open to, I think you want to perform.